Hey guys, welcome to another YouTube video. Today I'm going to be talking about where I'm at with my writing. If you don't know, check out my most recent video. I'm participating in Kate Kavanagh's 100K challenge. That's 100K words in quarter four, which is October through December. Obviously, it already started. It started 11 days ago. I've been a little sick, so that's why I haven't been able to make a video, but yeah, so if you haven't, definitely check out that video. And if you're not doing a challenge, I'd recommend joining it. It's not too late to join. So according to the goal, I'm kind of like 10,000 words behind where I should be-ish. Because I've only written like 2,000 words in the past 11 days. But I've been really busy with cross country and it's been hard to start writing. I haven't written in so long, so like coming back to it, like I kind of forget how to write, if you know what I mean. But I'm going to kind of go back and talk a little bit about where I'm at for Four Queens Fates and Crowns of Bryn, and like where I'm at with all my work in progresses. It's going to be kind of a jumble rant today. I do apologize for the lack of format and my pauses and stuff like that. Alright, so I've written, if you don't know, the past 2.5 years about, I've written 6 drafts of Four Queens Fates. And the 6th draft, I was like, this is the final one, I'm going to get this one published. I knew I'd have some editing, I gave it to some beta readers, and then I got so much feedback. And I found that there's so much to fix, and then like at first I read it and I was like, this is really good. Like, it is really good. However, there are a lot of problems and I can make it so much better. There are like literal plot holes and pacing issues and like stuff like that I need to fix. So, and like some world consistency stuff. So like it needs a ton of editing, like some heavy editing. I would have to like pick things apart, pull them together, rewrite chunks, rewrite. And I was like, this editing is gonna take way longer. Like, it might be easier to rewrite at this point and it'd be so much better. I could still like pull paragraphs or lines that I really like, chunks, even maybe full chapters, but like lots of rearranging, making it better. So I have now decided that I need to do one final rewrite. I know I said I'd have this book published by the end of the year. That's not happened. At the end of this video, I'm also going to go into like how my New Year's goals are going. But yeah, so I'm sorry I'm not going to be able to get the book to you. I have another draft right, apparently. It's been a lot of time. But I also think through these past 6 drafts, like, I've gotten so much better at writing and I really found my writing voice. So that's pretty good, you know, especially for being 15, almost 16 years old. Like, I feel like that gives me a good head start and will help me be successful. So recently though, I decided I was going to take a break from Four Queens Fates while I waited for the rest of my feedback to come in, and I was going to write Crowns of the Bryn, which I will get into later and like tell you about it. But it's essentially a trilogy fantasy series, kind of like Four Queens Fates. So, more recently, one critique partner suggested that I could make Four Queens Fates into an 8-book series instead of a 4-book series, because the first book could easily be made into 2 books because of the amount of stuff that happens in it. Like, it'd be better paced if I split it into 2 books, like the same amount of work. So I've actually, like, I feel like that's a pretty good idea, and I see how I could totally do that, and I think it would make the draft, like, I feel like that fixes a lot of problems. So I think I want to do that. However, so now I'm torn between making a re-outline of Four Queens Fates and rewriting it, or focusing on Crowns of Bryn. I'm unlikely to finish more than one book this school year, and I want the one I finished to be my debut novel that I get published that summer, like next summer. I've always thought of Four Queens Fates as my debut series, but recently I've thought it could be Crowns of Bryn, like the past couple months, but now I'm not sure. However, another thought to consider about this is that it is true that agents are less likely to accept a series with many point of views from a debut author. So in that case, it seems like Crowns of Bryn would be more likely to get published first, because like if Four Queens Fates became an 8-book series and it had 4 point of views in first person, like it's a lot harder for the market, I guess. So in that case, I should probably focus on Crowns of Bryn because it's a trilogy and it's only 2 point of views. Or I could try to attempt to write both at once, but I only have like an hour per week to write based on my current pack schedule, so I don't think that would end up working out well, and it would just overstress me. And then another question would be, to what extent will I rewrite Four Queens Fates? Because I want to keep the first four chapters, I think. But since I'm splitting the book into two, I can put much more chapters between chapters. And the however, with the rotation between the four point of views, if I had to do that, I have to add four chapters between chapters. The timeline would just get screwed up. Besides, I think I can write the whole thing better and just take paragraphs or even lines that readers loved from the original draft. So I think I'm going to keep the first four chapters and then just, like, kind of go blindly from there with a new outline that I'll have to make. It's a whole process. It's going to take a lot of outlining, too, because I want to actually get it prepared to actually be the final draft. I'm not writing another one after this another one. This will be the seventh draft, so. And, like, I've spent 2 years, 2.5 years on Four Queens Fates, and I have to finish it eventually. But like I said, it taught me a lot, but now I'm stuck, and I'm not sure where I'm going with it. I'm invested, though. I have to finish this book. I have to get it published. Like, I feel like this is a good book, and it's a good story. It just needs work. One suggestion I had was also to rewrite Four Queens Fates entirely from one queen's point of view, but I don't think that's how the story is meant to be told. It just doesn't really work like that. Because, like, you're not supposed to know which queen wins in the end, so, like, if it was from the point of view, obviously you know that's the queen that's gonna win. So, yeah. But I've been kind of stuck trying to write the first chapter of Crimson Burn, and currently I'm, like, halfway through it, and about 2,000 words, and I finally just picked up the pace with it today, but it's taken me a while to get to, like, back into the act of writing. Like, it's hard to write after having not written. But, yeah. So, a little bit on Crimson Burn. It's about two queens. Well, not two queens. Sorry, they're not queens. Two girls from different countries, both vying for the same crown. And I created this really, like, I created an amazing world. Like, the entire map, cities, all the stuff, different cultures, what foods they eat, languages. I created a really great world, in my opinion, and a great plan for, like, the series. I'm sure I've talked about it in one of my many videos, if you want to go check them out. But it's fantasy. And it's, like, more of a, I guess I'd say, like, in comparison, it's kind of more of a YA, I'm trying to, like, take a little bit of inspiration from, like, Game of Thrones, that sort of style. So it's more of a high fantasy. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. It's more high fantasy than Four Queens Fates, because that's a little more just, like, just YA fantasy. This is more, like, YA, but high fantasy. If any of this makes sense. Sorry, I'm kind of rambling. Yeah. I guess that's all I'm gonna say. It has, like, a lot of political intrigue, but also really cool concepts and, like, magic and dragons and stuff like that. Now, my final, like, point I want to talk about is my New Year's goals. I'm not really getting anything done. I made 24 goals for 2024. I think I was kind of stretching to try to find 24 goals, and they're kind of, like, they're very specific goals that it's hard to meet. And once my plans have changed, like nothing has gone according to plan, and I don't think I'm gonna achieve any of my goals this year. And I've decided, like, that's not the fault of me not doing my plans. Like, I've been productive. So I just need to make more realistic and achievable goals for next year. And also, my goals, somehow one of my goals was to get 10,000, reach 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. 10,000. I don't know why I decided to do that. I think I'm at 500 something right now. 510, which, thank you guys so much. But I think I'm gonna make a little mini goal of reaching 600 by December. So if you guys know anyone who would like my channel, share it with them. That would be so helpful. But yeah. So that's kind of my update for where I'm at. And I think, like, I'm still kind of torn between focusing on Crowns of Burn or rewriting Four Queens Fates. Because I'm gonna eventually rewrite Four Queens Fates, but I have to do so much plotting for that. And I really want to be writing right now for the Kate Cavanius challenge. Therefore, I'm going to focus on writing Crowns of Burn, I think. So I think I'm going to just write Crowns of Burn until December, and then by then I'll have all the feedback from all of my beta readers and critique partners, and can kind of look at it again as a whole, maybe edit Crowns of Burn, or send it to get beta readers for that, while I try to piece together Four Queens Fates, figure out what I want to do, re-outline, figure out what I'm going with that. But I want to focus on Crowns of Burn because that's the main priority, and I think that's what I want to try to get published next summer. So yeah, let me know if you guys, like, want anything specific as far as, like, this challenge goes. I know I don't really talk too much about, like, I don't have as many long form content, but if you want, like, vlogs, I can make some vlogs trying to document the new challenge. I'm really excited. I think it's a fun challenge and it's much more realistic. And I'm a little behind right now, but I think tomorrow I'm going to a Barnes & Noble to write with my best friend who's also a writer. So hopefully I'll get some writing done then and can finally finish chapter, because I think after I finish the first two chapters of the book, the rest of it's going to flow much smoother because I'll have figured out the character voice and I'll know where I'm going with the story, and then the inciting incidents happen, so it all gets more interesting and kind of picks up the pace. So I think that's going to be great. But yeah, let me know in the comments if you're also participating in the challenge, how your writing's been going, what your plans are for the next couple months, and what you think. Yeah, so thank you so much for watching. See you next one.